kind of memorial services is for us to learn and to imbibe from lives that are well lived. So with that, I invite our director, Dr. Srikant Tripathi, to welcome the gathering.
To welcome this sir, and to tuberculosis sisters in particular, and I joined the tuberculosis chemotherapy sector in 1962. I was appointed as a bacteriologist, senior research officer bacterial. The bacteriology laboratory at the center was established from scratch by Professor D. Mitchison. He was there as head of the laboratory for 1 year. And during this period, he recruited staff. Most of them had never had any experience in tuberculosis, except for two or three laboratory technicians given on loan by the government of Tamil Nadu. All the others were recruited and directly. They had no experience in laboratory work. Many of them were not even matriculates. They were recruited and they were all trained from scratch. In those days, we did not even have proper equipment. Some of the equipment was procured from abroad by WHO. Some were even imported from London, from his laboratory, for example. Even the studies in on monkeys were conducted, and guinea pigs were conducted. The cages were flown from England. Some of them came by ship. Many of the reagents were supplied from the his laboratory in London. So actually, it was his contribution remarkable in the sense that starting from scratch, he built a laboratory which is now one of the best laboratories in the whole world. He established the laboratory in 1961. And he was here only for 1 year, then he went back to UK, and Dr. J.B. Shankar took over from him. When he took over, it was a very full-fledged laboratory. It was very easy for Dr. Shankar to continue the work, and for me to continue the work when I was appointed as in charge of the laboratory in 1964. The British Medical Research Council was a part of a collaborative team with the Indian Council of Medical Research, the ICMR, the WHO, and the government of Tamil Nadu. And whatever TRC is today, it was because of the strong foundation laid by Professor Mitchison in collaboration with Professor Wallace-Fox. Both of them were deeply involved in formulation and conduct of the first group of clinical trials. And while the subsequent ones were formulated by us, they were, their guidance, advice was available throughout. Not only during the 10 years of the formal collaboration with the British Medical Research Council, even after that collaboration ended, he continued. We continued to consult them, and their guidance was always available to us. Both Fox and Mitchison were deeply committed to building up the human resource development, human resource element in the center. The staff recruited in the initial years were new to any research. Not only were they provided with the initial hands-on research, training and the studies progress, they were also provided with opportunities of research training in Professor Mitchison's laboratories and in Dr. Fox Institute in London through international fellowships procured with the help of Professor Mitchison and Professor Fox. They also arranged travel facilities for the center staff to attend international conferences abroad to present papers based on what they were class. In fact, I have personally benefited from this particular aspect of the assistance of Professor Mitchison. Thus they help the junior staff to be trained and to evolve into high quality research personnel who could conceive of new avenues of research, plan and conduct quality research projects. Professor Fox and Professor Mitchison not only helped in the establishment of the Madras Center, they were deeply involved in establishing research centers in other countries, Hong Kong, Singapore, East Africa, Kenya, and other countries. These centers benefited a great deal by interactions with each other and conducted independent studies of very high standard, international standards, avoiding duplication and sometimes collaborating with each other. As a result, Professor Mitchison and Dr. Fox played a very large role in the conduct of research in tuberculosis globally in association with the WHO, International Union against Tuberculosis. Because of this, their contribution, we can visualize the possibility of seeing a tuberculosis-free world in the coming decades. In this retrospect, I realize that much of my career development could be attributed to what I learned from the Mitchison Fox team. My original plan of returning to the teaching profession after 2 years of research at Madras was scrapped, inspired by the team I continued to medical research, which I pursued through my entire career. I have no regrets that I did not go back to a teaching job in the medical profession. The world will miss Professor Mitchison. His contributions to medical research will always be remembered. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
It's so nice to hear these kind of words that come from the heart. I always say sometimes we tend to forget how TRC, TCC, NIRT was built. And it's even more humbling when you find stalwarts like our own Dr. S.P. Tripathi, and we're going to hear from the others, acknowledging the fact that these are people who have mentored and even, you know, built TRC brick by brick almost. I think that's such a beautiful thing when he said he just trained people who had no training and he just from scratch to be able to develop a department. I think sometimes these things are taken for granted and I'm so glad we are listening to people like that. We will now have a small little ceremony. Usually you are lighting the lamp when you start a function, but this is just to say that these kind of lives, that's why I was waiting for somebody to kind of brief us about Dr. Mitchison, because many of us don't know, to be able to say that these are people who have set the light and let us set that spark burning and let us keep that burning even as NIRT grows and even as we work together for TB elimination. So I request Dr. hope that this light keeps burning. I would now request our very own Dr. S. Radhakrishna to take us down memory lane with his experiences with Dr. Mitchison.
Of Dr. Mitchison. But it is an assessment of Dr. Mitchison as a professional, bacteriologist, medical person, researcher. Now, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a bacteriologist, I'm a researcher, of course, but more importantly, I've been a close collaborator of Mitchison. I first met Mitchison 62 years ago in 1956 when the center was started, and I last met him when was it 2010, 8 years ago, when I went for the Fox Memorial Service at the Royal Society of Medicine in London. He was very healthy then, and we spent quite a bit of time talking to each other. So, memory goes on a long time. A few words about the Mitchison I know, and then others will take over. Dr. Mitchison was a close friend and a research collaborator of the legendary Dr. Fox, who made waves with his home sanatorium study in the 1960s in Madras. Mitchison was a brilliant bacteriologist in this productive clinico-lab partnership that set the comb on fire with its path-breaking studies on the characteristics of Indian tubercle bacilli, notably drug sensitivity, catalase activity, hydrogen peroxide, virulence in the guinea pig, etc., and serial serum isoniazid concentration studies that opened the gateway for intermittent regimens of chemotherapy. His role in the design of TRC's control trials, their conduct and data analysis continued long after he left the shores of Madras, and the postal authorities in UK must have made a tiny fortune with the serial letters that he wrote to his deputy Selcon at the TRC. They came with a serial number so that any letter lost in the post could be traced and replaced. It was no exaggeration to say that the brainwave or principles of chemotherapy that were evolved in intestine Madras and several BMRC sites such as East Africa, Hong Kong, Singapore, etc., had the birth in the brilliant mind of Dr. Mitchison. Not very surprising actually that he was a brilliant mind, considering something that probably many of you do not know, that he is the nephew of the famous biostatistician Professor J.B.S. Haldane, who had then permanently settled at the Indian Statistical Institute, Calcutta. So that is the background about Mitchison. I joined the TRC in 56 and therefore saw him in action in the early days. So I am the only one who has seen EMA, that is early Mitchison activity, which like EPA is very, very, very effective. After setting up the lab, he left for London after just 1 year, but his close involvement with the center continued for several decades through annual WHO short-term consultant visits, endless phone calls, and a barrage of Mahabharat long letters to Selcon. The letters were about 6 or 7 pages long, and they came with a serial number, 382, 384. So Selcon would write, "Dear Denny, I haven't got 383. Please send a copy." Because 382 had come, 384 had come, 383 was lost in the post. So Selcon had to write and say, "Denny, I didn't get 383. And now I last met him at the memorial meeting for Wallace Fox at the Royal Society of Medicine in 2010. And then Mitchison made a 7-minute PowerPoint presentation. All those who went, I went from India, were given 7 minutes to talk about Fox's contribution. So when it came to Mitchison's turn, he gave a brilliant 7-minute PowerPoint presentation and summarizing Fox's stupendous achievements in less than 10 PowerPoint slides. And he ended his talk, I won't forget it, with a flourish after he'd done the last slide and said, "This is Fox's contribution." He just looked at the picture and said, "What a great man, what a great contribution." And that was the end of his talk. Now for some personal experiences. When I was in London in 61, 63, in connection with my research training at the MRC TB unit and my own PhD at the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine, I used to visit Mitchison's home in Richmond, Surrey, and interact with him and his family over a cup of tea and mouth-watering Scottish biscuits, very, very famous Scottish biscuits. The high tea was usually preceded by a game of shuttle in their backyard, in which his children also participated, especially son Graham and daughter Susan, both of whom unfortunately are no more. We could not have had too many dinners at their home initially because of my strict vegetarian habits, until Ruth Mitchison, discovered a great solution, and that was to anoint me as a chief cook and throw her kitchen open to me for the evening with a variety of vegetables and Indian condiments that she picked up at a local store. The Mitchisons were hospitality personified, and I vividly recall that I was introduced to the famous London theatre, London stage by them, a visit to a theatre called Haymarket to see Terence Ratchett and play Ross, which was subsequently made as a film, Lawrence of Arabia. Mitchison and his wife Ruth, the children, and Subhaya, the TCC bacteriologist on a WHO fellowship at the time, constituted a large group that went after the show for coffee and some eats in a Piccadilly joint at midnight. This was quite an unusual experience for me, steeped as I was in the conservative Madrasi culture of Sahir Sadam at 8 p.m. and in bed by 9 p.m. And there I was gallivanting in Piccadilly Circus at midnight with Mitchison and his family. The MRC had an animal station at Porton in Wiltshire, at which Porton, Mitchison's group undertook vigilance tests of British strains and Indian strains of typical bacilli. When I expressed a desire to see this activity myself, Mitchison took me there while driving at 80 miles per hour. He was a great racing driver on the highway, driving at 80 miles per hour. He was sitting in the front seat, I was sitting in the back seat, and every now and again, Mitchison was one person who could never separate an ordinary conversation from the subject. He would keep talking about the subject, and suddenly in the middle of this drive at 80 miles per hour, I was sitting in the back, he would leave the driving wheel, turn around and say, "And Radha, you know the sample size for that," and then turn around. And there about half, you see, 80 miles per hour, and this man is turning around, driving a car, and gesticulating to me about some statistical design of experiments. So that was, when you went into that work mode, everything he forgot. He forgot that he was driving a car, he forgot that he was responsible for the lives of three other people in the car, I and two other colleagues of his, and went on. When we reached Portal, eventually, in one piece, the authorities said I could not enter the lab as a visitor because it was a high security establishment which had something to do with the military. So I was wondering what to do. The wily Mitchison got around this by appointing me as a score reader of autopsy organs. When you do the vigilance test and autopsy, somebody's got to say liver 13, something 14, somebody's got to record it. The person would know. And some record. So he anointed me as a recorder of the score. So the transformation then from Madrasi to Chaprasi was complete. After Ruth Mitchison's demise, Mitchison married Honora, a very bubbly character who infused new enthusiasm into him. And the pair of them, soon after their marriage, came to Madras when Subhaya and I organized a trip to Mahabalipuram, which I greatly enjoyed. When I visited London the next time in 2010 for a Fox Memorial meeting, Honora took me out for lunch to an Indian restaurant in Richmond. Then we went home to his home for tea. When I asked why Mitchison hadn't come for the lunch, his wife replied that he didn't relish Indian food, but he certainly relished Indian bacteriologists, Indian statisticians, and he ate it up. In recent years, I had little contact with Mitchison, who went into a shell after a sudden demise of his wife, Honora. But the annual exchange of Christmas cards between us continued without a break for 53 years, 1963 to 2016. I'm thinking of writing to the Guinness Book of Records. We have people living in different continents sending annual Christmas cards for 53 years without a break. That is Mitchison and I. It was only last year, 2017, that he didn't write himself because he wasn't very well. But he got his daughter Claire to acknowledge my greeting and wish me well. I understand from Gay Fox, to whom I spoke a couple of days ago, that Mitchison died on the 2nd of July, fortunately after a painless heart attack. His older son, Graham, had died of a brain tumor a few months ago, and this had depressed him greatly, according to his daughter Claire. In conclusion, Mitchison was an outstanding scientist with such a genius. The personification of hard work, as a good leader, at the same time an excellent team man. And it was teamwork that made Ditya excellent team man who inspired all who came into contact with him. His contributions to tuberculosis are immense and well acknowledged by national and international bodies. This institute owes its birth and instant success to him and Fox, and owes a great debt of gratitude to him. On a lighter note, we may well label Mitchison as a founding mother, since we usually refer to Fox as a founding father. Let us all take this opportunity to thank Mitchison for his labor and contributions and pray that his soul may rest in peace. Thank you.
How do you do it? How do you do this, Dr. Radhakrishna? I mean, it's just amazing the way you just, really when you say go down memory lane, I was just thinking Dr. Mitchison up there must be just so happy. And for people to remember so distinctly the early Mitchison activity, I like that term, and a combination of this personal, scientific. I really wish things like this would continue where you can mix work, pleasure, you know, the bonding, 53 years and Christmas cards, I think it's so fantastic. And to feel that you are a part of it all. I just thought what we can do now is open the floor for anybody who wants to speak. Yeah, and after that we can have it. Dr. Piaras, would you like to say something?
Minimal acquaintanceship with Professor Mitchison. And one thing about his family, which Dr. Alakshan was telling you about Dr. J.B.S. Allen. His mother, Mitchison's mother, Naomi Mitchison, was also a well-known novelist. In fact, she is supposed to be Goyan of Scottish novelists. And I think he had a brother also, Dr. N.A. Mitchison, who is also an immunologist. So he comes from a distinguished family of scientists. My first acquaintanceship with Professor Mitchison was when I came for an interview for the post of junior assistant statistician. He asked me two questions. First one I was able to answer, and that is about the standard error of the mean, which I was able to answer, sigma by root n. But then he asked me what is the standard error of the standard deviation. I said, sorry, I don't know. After that, I didn't have much contact with him. I was just a worker doing a routine recording in the statistics department. But later on, after he left India, in 1970-71, I was in Dr. Fox's unit for about a year. At the time, I went to his unit in, I think, Hammersmith Hospital. I don't remember very much about discussions with him and his assistant, Dr. Jean Dickinson. What I still remember is that his secretary gave me tea without sugar, and I usually take 2 spoons of sugar. Somehow, I managed to gulp it down. My last meeting of Mitchison was in India. I think about 15 years back he was here. I missed his meeting in TRC. But then I went and visited him the next day at Hotel Park Sheraton. I almost missed him because he had moved out his vacated his room. And I was about to go out when Dr. Radhakrishna saw me and called me saying he was sitting in the lobby. So he started with me for some time, and then when I said my wife and daughter were in the car in the parking space, he came with me, had a chat with him, and I admired my car also, my new Wagoner, saying it's quite popular in Germany. Apart from that, I think as Dr. Akshan and Dr. Tripathi have said, he's a very eminent scientist and all full of energy. I think he's full of ideas. Almost every day he'll have a new idea and then discard it when they found it was not correct. He's one of the, I think, I was with him in, from 57, probably 57, 58 he was here. I was though I didn't quite contact with him, and didn't have close contact. I pray that he will have well-deserved rest, having finished the age of 98, I think his mother was had completed 100 years. He was just about 1.5 years short of that. Thank you.
Now I invite, so sad that Dr. P.R. Narayanan was not here. In fact, he was instrumental in coining that hall, Fox and Mitchison. So he has sent a note through Dr. Geeta Ramachandran.
Good evening, everybody. I'm reading this condolence message on behalf of Dr. P.R. Narayanan, a former director. NIRT must be really saddened to hear of the passing of one of the leading TB bacteriologists, Professor Dennis Mitchison, at the age of 98. As a previous employee of NIRT, I share their sadness. With his erstwhile colleague, the late Dr. Wallace Fox, Professor Mitchison designed the most famous Madras study that changed globally the way TB patients were treated. He established TB labs in many countries. He not only established TB laboratory at TCC, presently known as NIRT, but also guided research for several decades. He authored more than 250 publications and received many prestigious global awards. His characteristic laugh, his sudden silence during heated discussion of protocols, his humorous discussion on English versus Chennai breakfast for a study at TRC, his strong opinion on EBA studies that he wanted to start at TRC that never got started, and many more can never be forgotten by me. I can also not forget what a great host he was when on more than one occasion he had invited some of us to his home in London. Professor Mitchison was a founding member of the TB Alliance's Scientific Advisory Committee at New York for more than 5 years, and I had the privilege of being a member of that committee along with him. His strong opinion during discussions always used to generate a lot of heat, but the reward of rich learning experience for many of us in the committee kept us cool. We will miss a genuinely true knowledgeable expert. His loss is a loss to the TB world. I pray that his soul rests in peace.
Dr. Radhakrishna has also got a message from Dr. Subbaiah.
Subbaiah, before I read out his, what he said. Subbaiah was a bacteriologist, the first bacteriologist here, who worked in 56. He and Gangadharam were the people who actually worked shoulder to shoulder with Mitchison in that initial phase. He then went to England to do a diploma in bacteriology at the Distill Institute of Medicine. Then he did a PhD, and he then went to the USA. He went to different places. He never came back to the TRC to work here. When I got the news about Mitchison's death, I immediately sent an email to Subbaiah. He rang up within 15 minutes and talked to me for about half an hour on the phone about Mitchison and the good old days and Gangadharam. And then 24 hours later, he sent me this letter, which I will read out to you. My dear Radhakrishna, I have shared on the phone some of my initial thoughts after Professor Mitchison's demise and how much his absence makes us poorer in our knowledge on strategies for successful chemotherapy of tuberculosis and eventual eradication of this dreaded scourge. He was a colossus, could be called almost Saint Professor. Professor Dennis A. Mitchison, as he preferred to be addressed, was a giant of a pioneer in the architecture and strategy of domiciliary chemotherapy of human tuberculosis, a joint enterprise undertaken with all the risks of a new venture beginning in the early 1950s by Wallace Fox and Mitchison, MRC of UK and WHO. The standardization needed to quantitate both clinical parameters and correlating laboratory tests needed a superhuman effort at the time, particularly when visualized in the complete absence of automated and advanced techniques now available. Those of us on the lab, me, your good self, Dr. Gangadharam, Srinivasan, Ramamurthy, Alexander, forming the technical support to come on par with MRC of UK, streamlined to fit into an architecture that could stand not only a statistically verifiable critique but of clinical correlates on the impact of long-term chemotherapy. The foundation which is laid at the TCC Chennai stands as a testimony to the acumen, foresight and his deep understanding of the disease and its causative agents that coexist, often hidden and insulated in the host. No job was too small for him. He tirelessly participated in what many may call menial tasks, repairing a packaged gas plant, a damaged gas plant in the lab at midnight for the lab to function next morning, to stand the inoculation loops site to lift exact amount of tubercle bacilli for drug sensitive test, sterilizing eggshells before collecting the fluid got intubated, etc. No detail was too small for him, not a complex experiment, particularly with hamsters was too difficult. He was, in short, the perfect scientist. Professor Mitchison was a trusted colleague and friend in all its true meaning, giving guidance at all times. He shared his family value systems. He brought to the lab when his maternal uncle Haldane, Mr. TCC. We were impressed by the informal eminence. Similarly, Professor Mitchison brought his mother, Mrs. Naomi Mitchison. Her husband was a Labour MP, eminent author, and spent her time in Swaziland. I had the pleasure of meeting him in UK at his residence. All the brothers are Mitchisons themselves, great scientists in immunology, cell and molecular biology. Gay Fox used to tell me that the Mitchison family, one thing that was common about them was the brothers were all brilliant and all extremely critical of each other. Each of them would underplay the achievements of the brother. Mitchison would do it to his brothers. She said, the funny lot rather, they're all very great, but they all keep criticizing each other. Professionally, I mean. I had the pleasure of playing a host to Professor Mitchison and his family during their holiday visit to Baroda and took them to Ajanta and Ellora Caves, Aurangabad, where he delivered guest lectures and a visit to Kashmir. So this, and then he sent me a letter note to say, to emphasize that Mitchison worked at a time when we didn't even have a Xerox machine, no stencil machine, no phones, no cells, no nothing, no computers, none of the modern gadgets, and in this very primitive world. So not even decent electricity all the time, or gas, in these primitive circumstances, and that makes his achievement all the more greater because he had very few facilities, but he turned out great things. Like his friend and collaborator in arms, Fox, I think the two of them did a very great job, and that is why we are all sitting here today, you know, enjoying the fruits of their initial labors. Thank you very much.
You don't need to come here and say something. You try to say something after you have heard all these great things about Dr. Mitchison.
I never worked with Dr. Mitchison. I joined the DRC in 1976. He had left by then. He was not here. But his spirit was everywhere. You go to the lab, you go to the stats department, the clinic, everywhere in fact. You hear, no, but Mitchison would say that. No, according to Mitchison, this is the way it should be done. And you heard Mitchison all the time. So that I seem to have imbibed his spirit. I didn't realize this all these years. When I saw Dr. Srikant's email, there was such a jolt to my heart which I thought I would never, which if somebody had told me I would feel this for Dr. Mitchison, I would have laughed. But I really feel that loss. There was one thing about him. I saw him, I think, in 78 when this building was inaugurated, or some meeting in this building. He was standing there, right there where his photograph is. And he said, the only way you people can control tuberculosis is to have lab services in the districts. I mean, at that time it seemed such an impossibility. Have lab services in districts, in the peripheral hospitals. But that's what we are doing now. Now in the TB control program, we are thinking of putting lab services in district level. Districts, culture facilities in districts, and so many things. He was such a far-sighted person. He was a real dear brother. when I saw him for the first time, that also was in this hall. I said, what a contrast. Dr. Fox, a straight-laced, stiff upper lip English gentleman. But Dr. Mitchison was a Santa Claus. He was a jolly Santa Claus. He had that twinkle in his eyes, and if it was pulling your leg, that twinkle would get deeper and brighter. Then you'll know he's pulling his leg. This is what I remember about him. I never worked with him. I had moved to the TPT by the time Mitchison came here as a consultant. So interaction with Mitchison was minimal and casual, incidental whenever I saw him somewhere. But then I learned the principles of virulence testing of the viable count from Dr. Mitchison. From there we went on to talk about principles of chemotherapy and how this was almost a one-to-one thing. How you have to think of how the drug acts before you put it in a regimen. This was new to me. I was very young at that time, I was green. I was not very young, but I didn't know much about TB. I had joined here not many years. But these were things that made me think deeply. And till I saw the notice about his death, I didn't realize how much these had shaped my thinking. I just wanted to share that with you. And I think his soul will rest in peace if we continue the work that he started for us here. If we continue to set the standards that he set. I think that's important. Setting the standards of our founding fathers, I think would be the best tribute that we can pay to him. May his soul rest in peace. Thank you.
Mr. Jayaraj and Dr. Pogutti would like to speak. I'd also like to mention here, especially before they come, I want to really thank Dr. Ramalingam. He's one person, every time there's an emergency, you just have to call him to be able to get that beautiful photograph framed. And also our friends here, Bala and Vinod, who helped with the music, and also our video friends here, who came in the middle and we were all trying to set it up. Thank you so much. Can I call?
Good evening to everybody. Our godfather, Dr. S.P. Tripathi and Dr. Radhakrishna and other dignitaries and our new staff of the and NIRT. Because always I used to TCC, because I was appointed in 1958. Dr. Mitchison was 1 year only with us. So 1958, at the time, people were afraid of to come and join in the laboratory work. Nobody is prepared to come. See, when I marry, unfortunately, marry one person was appointed here who is an orphan adopted by an Anglo-Indian family. He knew to talk English very well with those people. At the time, laboratory chief Dr. Shalkan, and he's a visiting scientist only, Dr. Mitchison. And Dr. Fox in the clinic, Lamashni in the clinic. And Dr. Enberg in the radiology department, Dr. Shalkan, Dr. Bhatia, Mr. Subbaya, and then Dr. Gangadharam also was there. At the time only I joined in the bacteriology. I myself and Mari went to ask the room for the rented house. Where are you working? He said, is it a TP hospital? No, you be there because children are here. So that much afraid of that about the TP disease. But at that time in the laboratory we were trained. Particularly, Dr. Mitchison gave training me to handle the animals. I was appointed in the animal department. He taught me how to take 10 ml blood in one prick in the heart without killing the animal. That is the technique we learned. And also, we had a certificate from all over the world. The world best technician, animal technician, Mari and Jaran, the same laboratory at TRC. So like that, then I was there in animal house for only 2 years only. At the time, Holmes was the WHO technician in charge for the laboratory. So she, one day she saw my handwriting. No, you don't be here, you come to the laboratory and take a patient's name and recording other things. Then I joined there, Dr. Tupati knows about all the stories. Then I went inside the main laboratory and learning how to put the cultures. Per day, 72 cultures, 5 technicians used to put it. Then you can count like that, 6 years I was doing work. But 1 year, all the animal work I learned from Dr. Mitchison.
I could not speak properly sometimes. Gerard, you have to come here. I was waiting and tomorrow we have to set up one set of animals to be injected. Every week or every month we used to kill 120 guinea pigs after giving the injection, positives. Every time you had a good idea, one day you will come, Mari, you have to check all the racks to the other room, leave it like that is not good. Why means? Every time you want to keep the animal's room perfectly sterility. That way he prepared, everyone trained us to keep clean all the rooms. Like that we were training and do all the things. Firstly for him, 1 year only I was with him and this is the experience. Particularly the animal work I have learned. Then bacteriology I started did all the other works. Then transfer to the radiology 7 years. Then I started myself immunology. He gave me a promotion in the immunology department. I was the first person who started in this department, the immunology. And then I returned with Kauraswamy for 12.5 years. The lymphatic virus study got a very good results. Last month we had the same meeting and Dr. Eric Carson told everything about it. So this way I enjoyed it in this theater, including Dr. Mitchison's experience. Thank you very much to give you the chance for me.
Good afternoon. I really feel honored and that I had a chance to kind of interact with him. I joined in 1981 and that time no clue of the founder of NIRT or the history of NIRT. So slowly we started hearing the names of Dr. Wallace Fox and Dr. Mitchison, but we had never seen him, so we could not understand what they had contributed to the institute. Later, I think it was late 80s or early 90s, I was working on an EBA study along with Mr. Ilam Purnam in the annex, the old annex. Suddenly there was kind of commotion and it was under, that study was under Dr. C. N. Paramasivan. So he came into the lab and said, Komati and Ilam Purnam, be ready, Dr. Mitchison is coming. We didn't know, and I said, so what? Okay, let him come, we are already doing our work. So he came and it was like a big hurricane hitting us. He walked in and he looked at all the kind of plates that we had prepared and the kind of documents that we were keeping. He said, fine, excellent, fantastic recording. So he also gave us some clues as to how to record and all that. And then he had a long discussion with Dr. Paramasivan. So I mean, we were just standing there completely, like dumbstruck. And he was going on giving, and such knowledge that person had. That was the first time I really had seen what he was capable of and what he had contributed to NIRT. And it's like, I'm grateful that I'm working in an institution which were founded by such great persons. Thanks for the opportunity. And I pray that your soul rests in peace.
We now come to the end of the program. Would like to thank all those who have spoken kind words of felicitation in honor of Professor Mitchison. Let us, in his honor, let us stand for 2 minutes of silence.
Annual report, we'll send this also along with this.